I'm confident I can continue in this work.
Government bills, first reading. Employment Amendment Bill 2021. Revenue first registration tax and license fees for motor vehicles Bill 2021. Public officers candidacy and taking up offices miscellaneous amendments Bill 2021. Revenue stamp duty Bill 2021. Revenue tax concessions Bill 2021. Second reading, Secretary for Labor and Welfare. President, I move that the Employment Amendment Bill 2021 be read the second time. The bill seeks to increase progressively the number of statutory holidays under the Employment Ordinance Cap 57 from 12 days to 17 days on a par with the number of general holidays other than Sundays. The proposal of alignment was made by the Chief Executive in early 2020. The bill sees the following. That is, the number of statutory holidays should be increased progressively with one additional day every 2 years until it reaches 7 days on a par with the number of general holidays. The 5 additional days of statutory holidays should fall on general holidays that are currently not statutory holidays, and they should be increased in the following sequence. The birthday of the Buddha, the first weekday after Christmas Day, Easter Monday, Good Friday, and the day following Good Friday. Other provisions governing statutory holidays under employment ordinance should remain unchanged. In formulating the above proposals, the government have given due regard to interests of both employees and the economy that have suffered greatly under the pandemic. Statutory holidays are statutory employment benefits under EO that are applicable to all employees and eligible employees, including some 370,000 foreign domestic helpers working in Hong Kong and their employers. To ensure a smooth transition, the pacing of the alignment exercise is of utmost importance. We propose to add the statutory holidays progressively to provide sufficient time for preparations and adjustments so that the alignment will not put undue pressure on the manpower and operating costs of employees, in particular micro, small, and medium-sized enterprises in those sectors with a relatively high proportion of employees that are granted SHS only. Apart from business, households employing FDHS would also need time to make necessary arrangements to adapt to the change while their FDHs are on holidays. We propose that the first additional SH should be the birthday of the Buddha, which will fall in May 2021. As a standalone holiday that does not fall within the peak travel seasons nor long school holidays, the birthday of the Buddha as the first additional SH should be more manageable and less impactful for businesses, employers, and household and FDHs. We recommend amending EO in one legislative exercise instead of multiple ones, such that there will be a great, clearer roadmap and time frame of aligning the number of SHS with GHS. We have consulted the Labour Advisory Board. While there is no consensus between the two, there is no disagreement on the goal of increasing progressive the number of SHS until it is on a par with that of GHS and on the need to introduce the bill to LegCo. We have also consulted LegCo panel on manpower in January. Divergent views are expressed on the pacing of achieving the alignment. However, there was no objection that the government should proceed with introducing this bill into council. We understand that the labour and employer sector have different views on the pacing of the exercise. While some suggested that we should continue the discussion at the LAB until consensus reached between the two parties, there is little prospect that a consensus could be reached in the foreseeable future. Deferring action until a consensus is reached in LAB would mean that employees, especially the grassroots who are currently enjoying SHS only, will have to wait further to enjoy the additional employment benefits. It is roughly estimated that 1.2 million or 40% of the workforce in Hong Kong, not including government employees and also FDHs, will benefit from the proposal. It is incumbent on the government to take the views of employers and employees for the interests of the society. So I urge members to support the bill. I now propose the question that the aforesaid bill be read at the same time. In accordance with the rules of procedure, the second reading debate is adjourned and the bill is referred to the House Committee.
Secretary for Transport and Housing.